just so I get the idea, if I like just run up onto the stage there and cut the rope, she's gonna fall like 7 feet, right?
So what's happening is there's like a pulley that like they tie the rope around her neck, you know, with a noose, and then as the rope goes up into the pulley and then it goes to a crank and then they start cranking it and it starts lifting her off the ground.
Oh god, that's terrible. So they don't do like the trapdoor instant choking thing?
Correct.
That's horrible. So if I cut the rope, I won't drop her 7 feet. I'll just drop her like 6 inches.
Well, like as you're approaching, they keep lifting her. From the space, you would guess she would get to about 5 feet off the ground.
Is that because in the movies they throw a sword so the people can dance on it and not die?
What?
Oh, that's the trap door one.
Ah!
That's like the right way to hang people.
Keep your swords, everyone.
That's considered the humane way, is you drop and they break
their neck.
So were
they like in the process of already hanging her when we got here?
They had the rope around her neck when you guys arrived.
I thought there was going to be like some fanfare and I was going to be able to like make my way up to the front of the crowd.
What happened? Like when you guys got there, they were reading her the last rites and putting the thing around her neck, kind of thing.
The Miranda rites?
Sure. Not quite, but you know, something similar to that, I guess. It's much more like you're a witch, and we're gonna kill you now. Okay.
Those are not very long rites.
No, she's not a witch. She's my wife.
Aha! Ha 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 ha. Let's get some more people in here. I don't even care what they look like anymore. Oops, I just need more people.
How do you just randomly generate them so fast?
I've got this list of on the side of my screen. When you guys see the recording, you'll know what I mean. Nope, not a merchant. We don't need merchants here.
Oh, that yeah.
We might want to stop and buy potions. Yeah. What was the
passing
fight?
Out apples. Somebody passing out drinks for the show. Fruits for the show. Whatever.
Sweet. Rotten quite tomatoes to throw at her. Cabbages.
There's an alchemist randomly.
It's definitely going to be the healer. Throwing the first tomato.
Ooh, here's an interesting person that might be wanted to talk to.
They all look interesting to me.
I want every single backstory, please.
Here's a especially guy with a fish.
Oh, he's always here.
That's better than a fish t-shirt.
Oh, perfect. The drum player playing the drums to die to.
You know, that famous song, the drums to die to.
You know how there's always like a drummer at a hanging, they like dun, 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 and then they start hanging them.
No.
I'm thinking Pirates of the Caribbean. There's always drums at the hanging.
What kind of hangings have you
I mean, that's
to?
A very British thing to do.
Yeah, Pirates
I like
of the Caribbean.
I like in Scotland when they have people playing the bagpipe for every occasion.
Yeah.
But yeah, like, they do it at a hanging.
Pirates
no,
of the
they
Caribbean.
Do.
Watch them again every time there's a hanging.
It's like,
I believe it happened in the movie.
Through.
No, it's true. Yeah, because there's so many strippers at a fucking hanging.
But who's doing the fire breathing?
Oh, man.
Where are them strippers at?
The pyro.
Man, I would just hang out in there.
Hope this party never ends.
Like, oh, you guys got this. Thorn just walked away.
Don't bite me. I'm going to beat you up.
All right. Spread these people out a little. And you guys have been to hangings before, or at least seen them. Maybe not been to them yourselves personally.
You say, I don't want to go there.
But they're usually not super
festive.
They're usually more festive than this is. Like, there's a few people
getting more festive.
Yes. Like, this is a very somber, dark thing, where back in Treslum, it was like people kind of celebrated the death of somebody that was taught to be as an evil person, basically.
Burp.
Obviously, not everyone agrees, but...
Not at all.
But in Treslam, it was very much more a... you're a witch. You're evil. So we're going to hang you. Yay. Less evil in the world. We're here. Everybody's just kind of watching. Like, they can't do
anything
about it.
Passing out fruits and beers.
Yeah. Get the strippers. For the ladies, the Chippendale dancers.
There's only one courtesan type. Whatever.
I don't like all these strippers.
And there's a few guards. A couple over one over there.
Where's the distraction happening?
Over there. And the distraction... Hold on. Let me grab a lightning bolt. I shall show you. Lightning. That's not how you spell lightning.
Lightning bolt.
Lightning.
Lightning bolt.
Lightning. Come on. You butthole.
Lightning. Buttholes.
Lightning buttholes.
Lightning filled buttholes.
Fractured butthole.
Fractured transmitter.
So this is where the lightning comes down. Explosion. And then this guy is standing there. And he yells out amongst the he yells out over the crowd, saying, "You shall not take another one of our own." And then he proceeds to basically ignite like the building on fire behind him, and starts doing some crazy shit. And we're gonna do our first initiative ever.
Oh god.
She, cool. Way to convince him she's not really a witch.
Yeah.
Never kill that witch. I mean, no, she's not really a witch. Too late.
I yell up, "Oi! I'm trying to watch a hanging down here."
Elder, that's the person that we're helping.
All right.
They didn't know that.
Elder didn't.
He comes all in a hustle and a bustle, lighting buildings on fire.
And we're gonna have a random peasant on the turn list for a little bit of chaos.
How do I get this stupid?
Nice.
I guess I'll just put it on this.
I posted a new picture of myself.
Wait, where is it? Oh, there's the fourth. Okay.
New
you guys
ability.
Are a little more spread out than I thought.
What's the roll for initiative?
It is your reflex.
D6
oh my.
Plus reflex or D6 plus 3 plus reflex?
3 plus reflex.
3 plus reflex.
Is it a roll or is it static?
It's your dice pool. So, as a roll, yeah.
Okay. So, 3. Oh, right. Dice pools. I forgot already.
Initiative.
6. Does it explode like other things?
Yeah. Same kind of roll as other
interesting.
Things.
Interesting. So, do we go by successes? Is that how?
I think that works.
I guess.
Wait a minute. Why are you rolling D8s?
No, I rolled a D8 for damage just to test the macro.
Oh.
I'm going to test this macro and see if it works the way I want it to.
So I don't know if we said this enough, but it's 3 plus reflex.
Damn it, that doesn't work.
Yes.
Yes.
It's dice.
Are they with the explodings?
Yep.
Explode. Do you remember what the note is on a macro to add to the tracker?
It is and bracket, swirly bracket, tracker,
oh,
and
yeah.
Swirly bracket.
So I missed the and. Alright, so this.
Oh, whoops, I rolled twice. Well, I guess I have to take the first one.
Yeah. Only 3 successes on 6 dice, but it still worked, so I'll take it.
Well, I only had 1 success.
Did it work? It worked, yay.
It did.
And this guy.
Ha! He doesn't get to act ever. He falls asleep.
Oh my god. 0 successes. That sucks.
He literally fell asleep instead of fighting us.
Yep. He's like, I'm creating a distraction.
So that he'd just get like a 1 in that case?
Nope. He has a 0. So, you know, sucks for him. He basically crit failed his initiative.
It's garbage.
Failed more than me.
He's gonna crit success though, everything else.
Hopefully. We'll see though. Alright, let's see when the villagers go. Alright, Erevay, what did you get?
1 success.
1 success? Alright.
There's a lot of threes.
It's a lot of threes, so let's see how this goes. Thorn, well, you are first.
Oh, in for a bit of the rough and tumble.
Are you recording?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I'll double check that I'm recording.
Well, I've been recording.
Yes, okay. Everybody wouldn't mind to double check that they are recording.
So, is this guy looking at me right now?
Recording.
No, all the guards are basically looking up at the roof where the guy just exploded in.
All right, so
yelling shit.
I'm gonna.
He probably yelled something more intelligent than I did, like, "You've got the wrong one, and you shall never find our cults, you foolish mortals," or something like that.
Plus MC squared.
One can of Chef Boyardee is one serving.
It's just been revoked.
Excuse me while I whip this out.
Alright, so
magical.
If my move is 10, which, how much are all these squares? Are they 5
feet? 1.
You said they're 1?
Yeah.
Okay, well then. Good.
Each one is 1.
Okay. I will,
Is your move really 10?
I don't think so. I think.
What is the move again?
Mine is 10 as well.
Okay, I mean, so that means you guys' speed one. Is 2.
Yep.
My speed okay, yeah.
Is 2. So is it 10?
Yep.
Oh.
If your speed is 2, then your nearby is 10.
Oh.
But you can move up to 28.
Okay, gotcha. All right, so.
But if you move up to 28, then you can't really do much else because you basically just. Run.
That's all I do.
I'm gonna take out my. I'm gonna slip on my brass knuckle.
Nice.
Tap him on the shoulder.
Bruh.
And then do a. I think it's a power punch. Sucker punch.
Nice.
Sucker punch.
Hang on, I gotta get in momentum. Yeah, sucker punch him right in the face.
All right. So, with Sucker Punch, you spend 1 stamina, you increase your damage by 2 steps, and you will have -1 on your defense until your next turn.
Okay. Brutal. So do I have to roll the hit?
Well, yeah, you still got to roll the hit and all that.
All right. That's the hit.
You should have some sort of skill.
With that, so that's with brawling.
You're brawling?
Right. What I mean, I don't have...
What?
I said... I mean, that's the pool that I have is 5.
Okay. So, right. What... Do you have brawling at, like, competent or anything?
No, it's just regular. Just learned.
Alright, so you have unarmed combat at learned, basically.
Yeah. Yes, yeah.
Alright, and so then brawling is grace over might.
No.
So
that adds to my...
So the average of grace and might towards yeah. grace. Yep.
Okay, so it's 2, so it goes up to 7.
Okay. So you'll have 7 dice.
Okay. Okay, wait. There we go.
Wait, if you have an unarmed combat at just learned, then that's 0 dice. You don't have brawling specialized at all?
I have it. I took the specialty. I just don't have it at competent.
Competent is the first level of specialty.
Oh, well, then I lied.
Then I have okay. It. So that gives you plus 2 dice, then.
Okay.
So then you do have 7 dice, yes.
Okay, got it.
6 fucking successes. Oh, my God.
That's a lot.
All right. Let's see if this guy ducks out of the way in time.
Nope. Holy shit.
What the hell?
Oh, my.
Oh, my God. This guy, I think I picked the wrong guy to punch.
Well, now it's a roll-off, so just roll 1d6.
What a badass.
Apparently.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
No! Oh!
Oh! Roll-off again.
Oh, my.
Oh, did you need an exploding die or not?
It
No, just what? Just roll
1d6. It still
1D6.
Gives the result for the first oh, okay. die, so it would be fine.
I could just see him just, like, trading blows, like, dodging.
It's like, huh.
Double sucker punch.
Nice.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, if you were a 6-2-0.
Nice.
Got him. All
right. So let's see what happened.
It was more intense than it should have been.
That was great.
Gotta make sure. My...
Hey, where's the weight table? The, game?
The weight table for, like, how much you can carry?
Yeah.
At the beginning of the equipment?
It's either at the beginning of equipment or beginning of attributes.
Oh.
No, yeah, it's in equipment. So, page 670.
Page 670.
No, I don't have that many pages yet.
I might have an older book because it's not a different page.
So you said it goes up by 2 steps for the power punch?
Power punch, 2 steps, yep. So the standard punch, like.
With the knock, it's like a, it wasn't 1.4.
How strong are you? 3. Okay. And then.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then you have the mighty, don't you? So, melee attacks have their damage dice increased by 1 step, so you go up 4 steps. And then the sucker punch is an additional 2 steps. You can kind of already see where this is broken. All right, so you. All right, let's check the where's the damage? I need to organize my book better.
It wasn't one.
Yes, it starts as 1d4. Mm, it should go higher than that.
With 4 steps? 6, 8, 10. Oh. Yeah, it should be D12.
So you have 3 steps from might, 1 step from mighty, and then 2 steps from sucker punch. So that's 6 steps.
Okay.
So you're doing
holy
so you're
shit.
Doing you're doing 2D10 with this punch right now.
That's okay. So much.
Yeah. Oh, and your Because you are competent, I believe that adds one to the damage.
Yeah, I think every step in the scale is a damage, but not a step.
It's a plus.
Sky step. It's a plus.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you can just take 8 plus 1.
I will. I'm just making a macro.
Okay.
Because that.
Yes, competent adds 1 to the damage. Okay. So you deal 9 damage to this guy. That's insane. And he is unconscious. Boom! So you just like tap on the shoulder, he's like, what? A push! Right to the face. He's like, ah! And unconscious. Alright. This guy, you see, pull a revolver and starts shooting at the guy at the roof. Let's see if he does anything.
Oh.
Oh, nice. Successes. Let's see if the guy on the roof gets hit. Oh, he gets hit. That is unfortunate.
Yes, it is.
Back to equipment. Revolver's a D8. So a guy on the roof takes 7 damage. Ouch. That is unfortunate. He's not out yet, though. But that really hurts. And then the people in the crowd go a little crazy. Come on, dude. Let's move some people there. Move this guy over here. This lady goes this way. That person goes that way. Apples go flying.
Oh no, not gosh. The apples.
Ah, people are freaking out. Oh my gosh. Mostly running away from the roof where the lightning exploded things.
You should change the squares to 3 feet or a square.
Oh shit, you're right. Meter. Euclidean. Okay. There we go.
Alright, that's better. Perfect.
Alright. Tarn, your turn.
Is the gallows area, is that like hollow underneath? Can you get under it?
It's just some wood. It's a platform. There's like maybe a foot under it.
I probably can't slide 6 feet, so I will run. I'm going to. Oh, they're distracted. Let's see. I was hoping it was like 3 or 4 feet up, so I could like slide under it. Crawl.
No, it's just it doesn't have like the trapdoor thing.
Right,
it's just a platform that gets people a little bit above everyone else.
6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. To get to here is 10 squares if I run around the gallows. So okay. I'll do that. And then when I get to here, I'm going to just I can like double move, right?
If you go your far distance,
I just also want to try to climb up behind this guy without him hearing me.
Okay, what's your speed?
10. This would be 11. Well, this would be like 11 and a half if you count diagonals. So it's 1 and a half. All
right. You can move there. You're not going to be able to attack, but
yeah, that's fine. I just want to get behind him without him hearing me. So I'll
roll me a stealth.
Be slow about it. Stealth.
Boop a doop a doo.
Four successes.
Four successes. Let's see if either of these two gents notice you. Nope. And nope.
Yay.
All right. They do not notice you. Man, they almost did. And you'd have three more dice than them.
I'll have my dagger out, too. Or actually, I have my kukri out as well.
Okay. This guy is actually facing that way, and he's cranking the thing. That's what he does for his turn. This guy starts shoving through the crowd and goes right past you, Alder, to try to shoot the guy on the roof.
Well, that was a big mistake.
Ooh, one success, which means he probably didn't hit the guy. Ooh, shit. Well, that calls for a roll-off with myself.
Nice, bro.
So the first one's the guy with the gun. All right, he did not hit. Wonderful. And then that's the unconscious dead guy, so that doesn't really matter. This guy's trying to calm people down. Calm down, we have everything under control. Alder, it's your turn.
Great, so how does quick draw work?
You got the...
I do have the skill.
The skill, so...
Or fast draw.
Fast draw as the skill.
Yes.
Boom. Well, if you roll it and are successful, then you basically have it out and don't need to take any actions to draw a weapon.
Great. I have four successes.
Huzzah. In the case of, like, you versus somebody else, that would mean that you would get the attack first kind of thing.
Oh, okay. Okay. And then there was something that I wanted to do, so I just...
Chop his fucking head off.
That's what I'm going to do. I wanted to do... I thought I had it written down on my character sheet. Was it overhead chop? I think was the combat technique I wanted to do.
Overhead chop's a pretty good one. What that does is, foregoing your next defense action, you bring down your sword with all your strength to cleave into your opponent. You lose your next defense action and double weapon damage on this attack.
Yeah, I'll do that.
All right, costs one stamina.
Okay.
Should probably cost more, but oh well.
So I'm going to roll. So I'll roll attack. Oof. Oof.
Whoa.
Whew, not rolling dice tonight.
Something got in your eye.
Well, he's going to have a minus two because he's facing away from you, so... I don't have a dice thing low enough, so just a second. Okie dokie, and bloop.
Oh, balls.
Fortunately, he heard you draw the sword, turned and ducked just as your sword almost came crashing down at his head. Oh god! Stand down, citizen. This is not your fight.
I just kind of brandish my holy symbol on my chest.
All right. And he goes, ah, infidel. It's not the word they would use. What would they do?
It was good enough. I understood what you meant.
No, there was, they said the...
Religious radicals.
Waste. You are a waste. You will be cleaned from this world.
Oh, I gotta get the slang pulled up.
Yeah, this guy over here takes a shot at the wizard up top. Two successes. Does the guy get hit? No, he don't. Erve.
Is it assumed that we see everything that has verbally been said, or do I need to roll perception for that?
Yeah, everything is... It's a bright day. Not everything is... there's nothing really being hidden except Taren, so...
So, not one to fight. I am going to notice the guard to the south that's trying to calm people down. And I'm going to separate myself slightly from these people I know. And I'm going to start trying to calm people down.
All right. I'm
going to go this way. Kind of like into this group of three. Everyone calm down.
You want to roll me a diplomacy or charm?
I don't think I have those, but I'm going to look to see.
Do you have social as a skill?
I don't think so.
Oh, no.
Nope.
Well, then, roll me a charisma.
Charisma. So three plus charisma would be four.
Oh, no.
I am not calming people very well.
No, there's one woman that kind of stops for a second, and then a gunshot goes off, and she continues to freak out.
And that would be my turn.
All right. And then is the wizard. And he, with a few words and a couple of swooshy movements of his hand, launches a bolt of fire at this guy right here in front of you, Alder. One who shot him for quite a bit of pain.
So didn't two people shoot him?
This is true. So then he rolls to be successful. Gets a 5 to this guy with the firebolt. And this guy's reflex, he fails. He gets hit with a firebolt. I'm making up this damage because I don't have this spell as a thing yet. So, let's see.
At least you had a little ditty representing that, though.
Yeah! We'll say it's 2d6. So he takes 7 damage. He's in pain. Owie! So, as he was facing you, Alder, after you came down with your sword and you brandished your holy symbol, he then ignites. And Thorn, your turn.
Okay. I'm gonna step over this lad. Walk up here. Sucker punch this bro right in the face. Is that...
You just sucker punching everybody tonight, bro.
Strong two people.
It only costs 1 stamina, and I have 24 stamina.
He does have a lot of stamina.
All right.
Oh, God.
Dodge. When I say dodge this.
That time, I think you did it.
Fuck, man. All right, let's see if he dodges you. Not even close. But you didn't get a crit, so that's important. So,
wait. What did you say about crit?
You did not get a crit. If he had gotten one less success, you would have gotten a crit, though.
Oh, okay.
Yep, you gotta beat him by 5. So
this is
you
the
beat
dude cranking.
He's cranking the crank that's strangling the lady.
Gotcha. Good. Because he got punched right in the.
Holy
Jesus
fuck.
Jesus Christ.
Oh my god, you punched him in his fucking brain.
Literally, just you warp through his skull and punched him in his brain.
Yeah, so I put my brass knuckles get stuck in his skull, and I just put my foot on his chest. And he falls through the trapdoor.
Yeah, he just like falls off the backside of this thing. His head kind of a bloody mess. A little bit in concave now.
Mm.
Gross.
I'll just turn and, like, wink at his friend over here.
And that he right. starts running.
Oh, I didn't even get to slit his throat. Boo.
Boo. All right, hold on. We'll have a will save to see.
I mean, okay. He can run. That would be okay.
Nah, he's a man. He's going to try to shoot this guy who just punched out his buddy.
He's a trussy dog.
Boo.
He is a trussy dog. Highly trained soldier-ish. So, he whips out his gun and shoots at you, Thorn.
Oh, shit. I'm sorry, Thorn.
That's all right.
I should have let him run.
With a gun, there's no kind of save.
You just roll your badge.
I have acrobatics.
Well, there you
could
go.
I do like it? All right. I'll do
basically
a sweet backflip.
Like, if he were behind you, yeah, you wouldn't get a dodge. But in front
Damn.
Of you, you get to basically, to like, oh shit, a gun! Try to duck.
Duck behind the lady that's swinging in front of you.
I almost did a sweet backflip.
Almost.
You did the backflip, but still got shot.
Yep. As you were doing the backflip, he shoots you in the butt.
Okay.
So. D8 for the revolver. I think. Which, as you're beating these guys with 2d10, I feel like a gun should do more damage.
Or the pool is. I think you just need to reconsider the stepping of the pool. Or the
yeah.
stepping of the die.
It's probably more like it.
2d10 yeah, damage with damage. A fist at level, basically level 1, is a little excessive.
Yeah. You get poked for 1 damage.
Just but a flesh wound.
So if you have armor, that reduces it.
I have leather armor, yeah.
So if
is it the rating?
Yeah.
Okay. Does it take any hit point damage, or does it have to beat the hardness to take hit point damage?
It has to beat the hardness.
Gotcha. Okay. Well, then it just sort of like grazes off my shoulder, just like
yeah, basically.
I'm coming for that gun, boy.
Ah! Might and other things that currently step up the pool can modify the total. Each skill specialty steps the die. Oh, I like that.
So I think Thorn would be at 1d6 plus 5 or 6 right now.
Yeah,
which
so
is
if you're
pretty good damage for a fist.
Yeah, so if you're competent, it raises it by one step. That.
I mean, it's probably something we don't want to change right in the middle of this, but.
Yeah.
I
no,
figured I'd write it down
to think
somewhere
about.
So I forget.
Yeah, let me know.
Yeah. So for
cool.
today, we're keeping it the same. We'll just
okay.
try to figure it out before next time.
Gotcha.
Because that's ridiculous.
Awesome.
Yeah. Because then I'll see what like my normal punch is. Otherwise, I'm just going to sucker punch everyone.
Well, your normal punch is only 2 dice less than that, or 2 steps less than that.
So.
So, like not much different.
A D12 or something? Yeah.
Yeah, a D12.
Well, from 2d10, it goes down to 2d8. And then 2d12, so yeah. Or 1d12, yeah.
Yeah, so 1d12.
Yep.
Okay, cool. That's still for a naked punch. Or
well,
with just
brass
knuckles.
Punch.
That's pretty impressive.
Yeah.
Punching harder than those bullets hit.
Yep. It's fucked up. Taren, your turn.
Alright, I'm going to assume Thorn can get her down. And I'm just going to try to slit this guy's throat from behind.
Okay.
So I will use my gut ability.
Ooh.
So. Only 3 successes. That is garbage.
It is garbage.
Because he can't even see me.
Yeah. With all
Boo.
The excitement.
Boo, Wendy.
So he gets a -2 because you're behind him. He did not hear you in time.
Oh, I thought I only had 2. I had 3. Okay, good.
Yeah, you're good.
Okay. Double damage. So I do 2d4. That is not very much still. All right. A whole 4 damage.
It is doubled, so it's 8 damage.
Well, no, I only do a d4. I just rolled 2d4 instead of...
Aww. You need to raise your strength.
Yeah, I mean, he doesn't know I'm there.
Compared to these fists.
Thought slitting his throat would be cool, but...
You don't cut deep enough.
Yeah, I guess.
He screams, well, where's my beard?
Not strong enough to cut through.
Thanks for the haircut, Dirk.
I need an escape.
Aw. That guy's dead. This guy... Oh, man, what's he gonna do? Somebody set him on fire. Somebody tries to chop at him. He's gonna run over here and still shoot at the wizard. He is the bigger threat in his mind. Bang. Ooh, my goodness.
Ooh, the wizard's fucking owned.
Oh, God, yeah, he is. Depending on his damage.
So I don't fuck around, wizard.
4 damage. And you guys see this man get shot. He lurches and slides down the roof to the ground.
Oh.
Where he takes some falling damage. Fall hurt just as much.
Oh God.
As the bullet.
Then I die. Yeah.
I need to reconsider my bullet's damage.
Yes.
This guy is running over trying to calm people down. He had to knock out a couple. Alder, your turn.
Excellent. Well, let's see here. I gotta look. Alright. So... each movement is, like, if I have a movement of 10, it would be...
You can move up to 10 and
10 meters.
Basically do... Yeah, okay. Basically do whatever else. Man, everybody's so quick.
Yeah. How fast are your guys? Or are these crusty dogs?
I have them at a speed of 1, so they have nearby is 8.
Well, this guy, I'm gonna just go at him, go ham, if you will.
All right.
And I'm gonna try.
The wrath of the ham nation.
Oops.
Yeah,
my bad.
He insulted me, so
I got excited and rolled.
We're gonna try this again. There we go.
Chop. Nice.
Let me roll 2 more here. 2 more. Alright, so that is a total of 8 successes.
Wait, why were you rolling so many?
Because I got 6s.
Oh, it does the explode. It does the explode.
Oh, does it?
You.
Okay. Well, you know, yeah. I like to roll, so.
Well, don't have the exploding ones then.
Yeah, it is fun to roll. So you have 6 successes. He's going to try to not, you know, get hit. You definitely hit him.
Awesome. So,
tell me some damage.
So the overhand chop doubles the damage, right?
Correct.
So 20 damage.
Damn. He did.
Good.
He is now 2 people. Well, 2 half people on the ground as you split him from crown to groin.
I just spit on the ground and like mutter blood dog and put a pipe in my mouth. Just like slowly turn around.
Alright. Nice. Next is this guy. He saw what you did. He's gonna try to shoot you. No, Steve!
He was one day from
this dude sucks.
You don't even have to roll because he just completely
shoots,
you know,
the person next.
Yeah, just shoots this lady. No!
Get your vials out of here, woman.
I'm gonna say his gun jammed. So that is an utter failure. So his gun is jammed. He'll have to spend a couple rounds undoing like, no, that. Arave, your turn.
A smile and excitement.
I'm gonna notice this strange man get shot multiple times and fall off the roof. I'm going to go to, quote, apprehend him.
Nice, bro.
That's not where I'm standing. If I can move 7, am I allowed to go 7.1, or do I have to stop at 6.5? Why is my mouse not working anymore?
I don't know. You need a new meter. Hold on. There, I changed it to a Pathfinder compatible, so now try distance.
Well, my mouse doesn't work. I'm sad.
Oh. Yeah, you can move there. That's 7.
I can get to either spot. Who is also using a pink meter stick?
Me, apparently. My name is Green. That's weird. Whatever. So you're there to apprehend the person.
Yes.
Alrighty then. He's bleeding profusely. A lot. Thorn.
Alright, so when I punch this dude out, did the crank just go back and fall down, or do I...
The crank has like one of those lock things, so like every knob you crank it locks.
Gotcha. Alright, well I'm going to undo that. Actually, is there a rope connected to the crank?
Right, it's there. Like a set of gears that go up to a thing with the rope that goes to the pulley.
Okay, well then I'll just
like, so you could either cut the rope or you could undo the lock.
Alright, then I'll
it's either a lever pull or you cut the rope.
I'll just pull the lever since I'm right here.
Alright, so you slap the lever on the crank and she falls a couple feet to the ground, coughing and choking, and drops to her knees and crumples.
Okay. Where's she at?
She's right here.
Okay. Can I go pick her up?
My circle is blue, my ruler is pink, but my symbol is green. What the fuck? Alright, you pick her up.
I'll go pick her up and take the rope off.
Alright. Well, you pick her up. But all right, that's a lot I'll of things to do in one turn.
Man, what is this drummer boy doing?
He's stopped. And he started running.
I was like, is he just there keeping the beat?
Yeah, it's just like, yeah, war drum time. And this guy did not appreciate getting his throat slit, turns around to shoot you.
Yeah, I didn't do it very well. He can get over it.
He still doesn't like it.
Well, I don't like him.
2 successes. Let's see if you can not get hit.
Okay, so I have -2 P to defense because I used gut. Can I still use my dive aside ability?
Yes.
Okay, so I'm going to do that. So -1 effective. And I get to slide over here if I succeed. I don't have a macro for this amount of dice. If I don't succeed this, I'm just going to quit.
Is your dodge still
9 dice? So that doesn't succeed.
Jesus.
Okay, I think I dodged.
Oh my god. Yeah, so you can either be beside him or behind him now.
Well, I can't be behind him because I'd have to roll off the platform.
Well, it's only like a foot off the ground. So.
That's too many feet.
Okay, fine.
So I, like, as soon as he turns and goes to shoot me, I just dive around him.
He's like, what? The bullet goes with harmlessly into a building, killing a child.
Like with that, you just side.
Like, basically.
Nope, it's a sweet dive roll. That's how I operate.
A Bloodborne.
Well, it is how it's described, and it is basically like a Bloodborne dive and roll as he tries to shoot you. Yeah. People go crazy some more. These guys start running this way because there's blood and explosions happening over there. I'm so descriptive. Taryn.
Alright, so now I get to make a stealth versus his perception.
Yes.
And if I succeed, I do extra damage.
Where did he go?
Bah.
He was just here.
Okay, bah.
Why do I always suck at stealth
rolls?
Can I use my reroll filled stealth attempt on that for my trait?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm totally gonna do that. So I reroll it at plus two pool. So let's see if that one does it. Yeah, that
Damn.
One
does it.
Wait, that's not nine successes.
One, two, three. No, that is not nine successes.
Why is it so
you said nice? Less than four.
Oh, hey, that'll do it. Oh, I did that. I did that on my other one, but it was close to being true. I had one, two, three, four, five.
Oh,
I had five, not eight on my. So my stealth still succeeded anyway, but or not my.
The rolling 90.
Whatever that 96 was, my dodge succeeded anyway. Okay, so I need to fix that. It's like that's not nine. So three. So I still fail at the stealth. Because why have a dice pool of 10? Man, roll 20 really does hate me.
Yeah,
but I'm still
going
to try to hit him anyway. So just a regular old attack. Which then gets 6.
Alright. He's going to try to not get hit. And come on, dice. He gets hit.
Yay. I'll do a whole d4 again. Yeah, max damage.
Owie! Stop that, you! I don't appreciate this.
Well, I don't appreciate you overcoming my 10 dice pool.
This guy's working his way towards the stage, telling people to calm down. Alder's turn.
Excellent. I'm just going to smile and look at just splitting this guy wide open.
Wide open at once.
How does sweep work?
Sweep. Is that like the ability sweep?
Yes.
Okay. So.
Skill, actually. Just kidding.
Oh, like the skill. Okay. That's to trip somebody.
Cool.
With either a large weapon or like your foot.
Can I trip him with my flame bearish?
Yeah, that's definitely a big enough thing to trip him.
Okay.
You make a nice big sweeping motion at his leg to knock him down.
Let's do that. We'll see what my skill is. Okay. Two successes.
Two successes.
Oof.
It's okay.
Let's see.
That's right, okay. I'm gonna retaliate.
He maneuvers his legs out of the way. Does a little hop over your sword. And he draws his own sword. Swings it at you.
Excellent.
Three successes.
Let's see. So that would be dodge, correct?
You can either do dodge or block.
Let's see.
Because you got some big old melee weapon.
Let's do block.
All right. So,
just to make sure I'm adding it correctly, what does block entail again?
Block is reflex plus your skill, as opposed to an attribute plus your skill.
Okay.
So, like, what is your skill with two-handed swords?
Skill.
Yeah. Like
eight.
So you have it at,
the second, or the competent.
Competent? So you have it specialized once,
yes.
Basically. Okay, so that's going to give you plus two dice, and so then what's your reflex?
One.
Okay, so that's, so it'll be six dice.
Okay. Five successes.
Nice. So you deflect his sword way with ease.
I wink with my good eye.
And he looks a little worried. Erevé.
Okay. How far can I move and still do a full round action?
Your nearby movement.
Okay. I want to kind of...
Well, no, if something says full round action, then you can only take, like, a step. Because it takes your full concentration to do it.
How much time does a diagnose skill roll take?
That would be a standard action. Unless you're taking time, then you get bonuses.
Do I need to roll a diagnose to see if this person's gonna die?
Yeah.
I'm gonna roll a diagnosis.
Okay.
Which is knowledge / wisdom. I don't know what exactly.
Wits.
I lied. Knowledge well. And wits. Knowledge wits. And wits.
Wits. Yep. Sorry.
So how do I know which one?
The one that's first is the one you round towards.
Okay. So 3 plus knowledge, because I'm rounding towards knowledge.
Yep.
Plus I am competent.
So that'll give you 2 more dice.
So I'm going to roll 7.
Six success is nice. He is bleeding out and is going to die.
Do I know how many soon. How many turns I have?
You probably have a minute.
So 20 turns.
I know this is like the longest diagnosis ever, but can I tell, does he have a chance if I do first aid, or do I need to do more than that?
He would have a chance if you did first aid, yeah.
Well, then we're going to go right into first aid, which is,
alrighty.
I think, knowledge and grace. God damn it, my mouse isn't working again.
Yes, first aid is knowledge / grace.
Ooh, that rounds towards 1 instead of 2, because I'm not very graceful.
Oh, no.
But I am trained in that, so it's 6.
Nice. Jesus.
So much exploding.
So 5 successes. All right, you stop the bleeding. Looks like he's going to survive.
Oh, hopefully good.
He doesn't get an infection.
Well, I'm going to keep doing first aid.
All right. His turn, he does not keep bleeding. Thorn's turn. You have a lady in your arms.
Perception.
Yeah.
I'm going to take the rope off of your neck. And then turn around. Yes, and I'd like to sort of throw my cloak over her, if possible.
Okay.
It's crowding her, sort of head down, moving. Not running, but like quickly trying to like blend in, but get through the crowd.
Just like getting through the mess of crazy.
I was going to say, her people. Weight is probably going to make you at a different weight level.
How much does she weigh?
She weighs like 120 pounds. No, she would weigh less than that, like 100 pounds. She's a slight elf.
Okay, so I have minus 1.
So you only move... Well, it's a minus 1 to your movement, but when you go down 1 in movement, it...
Oh, okay.
Well, it goes... It goes to the table.
So. Okay, so 8.
Yes, correct.
Yeah.
Alrighty. So she's being carried by you. And then people continue going crazy. But they're mostly dispersing now. Doop-a-doo. Doop-a-doo. And you guys hear marching of people coming. Sounds like backup is arriving. So you better hurry. Oh, whoops. I skipped this guy. So he turns to face you again, Tarn. He draws a sword and tries to stab you with it. Ooh, 6 successes.
That'd be sweet if I could roll like that. Right. All right. So one more stamina to use dive aside again.
All right.
Doop doop doo, which gives me a 10 dice pool. So let's try that. Nope. Oh no, we did tie. At least there's that.
Oh, shit.
You know, twice as many dice.
Oh
man.
All right, roll off.
Oh, I'm not gonna be. Oh, I did. Yay.
Nice. All right. You dive right around him to his backside. Roll me a stealth.
Yeah, I'll try that again. Make sure that is what I think it is.
Okay. Ha ha! Ha.
Jeez.
There's some prettier colors. Nice.
5 successes against his 5 successes. Roll off! Oh, shit. I'm sorry.
Oh man.
You're having the worst luck with this guy.
Alright, I'm just gonna try to attack him on my turn.
Okay, it is your turn now.
And hopefully he dies so I can run away. 4 successes to slash him.
Alright.
Half. Slash him half. Right in half.
Oh god.
Oh my god, are you kidding? Why do you roll so well? Why is that a thing?
Seriously.
Is that the neon green dye?
Can I
get that green dye out of here?
Try to hit him again, or do I have to declare that before my first attack?
I'll say you can. It'll just be -2 to your pool.
Yeah. That part's in the book. I just didn't know if I had to declare it.
Right, no,
try
you have to declare
it. 4 pool anyway, because why not? The same amount of successes as my other one.
Let's see. Oh, yeah! You hit him!
Yeah! Did it!
There you go.
Max damage!
You beat the captain of the guard!
This is like the worst recruit.
Collapses and slips off of the thing. Thumpah.
See ya.
To the ground, bleeding out.
I'm assuming since I took 2 attacks, I can't move.
You can move, yeah. It just has to be within your near.
Oh, okay. Distance. 1, 2, 3. Oh, I guess I'll measure it since we're doing 4 meters. Alright. I'll run here in anticipation of Thorn coming this way as well. Wait, which way is the marching coming from? Can we tell?
It's coming from the north.
Okay, then yes, this is the way I want to go.
Okay. And then it is this guy's turn. He saw what you did, and he's going to try to shoot you.
Bullshit.
Kablamo.
Uh-oh.
Ooh. Uh-oh, 4 successes.
I will roll through the crowd. How much stamina do I have left?
Collateral damage.
That is right. I will... Can I use dive aside even though I'm not in melee?
No, that is a melee thing.
All right, then I will not do that. But effort costs 3 base?
Correct, to give you one more die. And then talent lowers the cost by the amount of talent you have to a minimum cost of 1 per level.
I'll just try doing it on my base dodge. Ah. Of course.
It is not your day.
No, it is not.
No, roll 20 just hates me every day.
That's true. So you take 2 damage.
Well, at least he rolled shitty damage. That's good.
Yeah.
Because I don't have very many damages to take.
Do you have any armor?
I have torso armor. Does that count? Is he shooting me in the torso? Oh, cool. So I take. Does that mean I take no damage, or is it minimum 1?
No, that means you take less damage. So whatever. Well,
it's rating 2, so.
And then you take no damage.
Oh, cool.
What's its hardness?
5.
Okay, so your armor doesn't take damage either.
Yeah, I knew I bought this it fancy leather coat for a reason.
Yeah. Alder's turn.
Excellent. Well, I'm gonna like kind of take like put my weight on my back leg, on my good leg, if you will. And like, if you've ever seen the movie Kingdom of Heaven, where like they pull the sword up in like a high guard, and then I'm gonna swing down on a slight angle at this dude's neck. So I'm gonna do another overhand chop.
Nice.
6 successes.
Holy shittles. All right, you bring up your sword, you bring it down to strike at his collarbone. You connect, dealing 21 damage, cleaving
that's doubled.
The collarbone, cleaving through the ribs and out by his hip. He looks down for a moment as his top half slides to the ground. Schlump. Holy shit.
Yeah,
level one characters, everybody.
The damage is technically doubled.
he explodes. Oh my
God. So you cut him into quarters with one slice.
Flunk, flunk. As you slice through him, somehow he also gets sliced the other way. Falls into pieces.
That's like some anime bullshit. Like,
yeah. Oh man, Arave's turn.
I want this wizard to live. I'm going to continue to first aid.
Okay.
So I am rolling 6 dice. Ooh, this one isn't as good.
Ooh. You apply some ointments to him and areas to prevent infection.
Yes.
You think he's gonna live? Pretty sure he's gonna make it.
Somebody's gonna walk up and shoot him now.
That's possible.
Alder's gonna drop his sword and it's gonna land in his throat.
I'm gonna do that.
You know, when you swing it and critically fail.
Aw, oh, dude.
Thorn's turn.
Don't do that shit.
I'm gonna double move.
You're gonna move a far distance.
Yep, I'm getting out of here.
Alright, so your far distance while carrying her is 24.
Oh, okay.
So you get the fuck out of here.
Yep.
Alright, you have now exited the scene. That guy is dead. And crowd continues to go crazy. I'm not going to really move them anymore. Taryn, your turn.
I run away.
Good choice. This guy. Let's see. He actually is going to run over to you, Arave.
Oh, wonderful.
You see him pulling out his manacles, and he's like, good, we need him alive for when we kill him.
Of course.
And he binds the guy's hands. And then it is Alder's turn.
Great. I'm looking around for Erevay, because that's important to me. And then I walk up, and I'm just going to strike this man in the back.
All right.
7 successes.
Holy shit. Well, he's got a -2 because he came up behind him. And you hit him.
Excellent.
And as he clasps the last manacle, the sword falls on his back. Dealing 7 damage?
Yeah.
Owie. All right. It gives him a deep gash. He yells out in pain. Ah! You dick! Erevay.
You know.
I kind of give that look to Erevay, like, run. Run, girl, run.
Where is he facing right now?
Towards the wizard.
Can I step back and get a bonus? Well, give him a penalty for not looking at me?
Yeah, what are you doing?
I'm going to have to step back and bop him in the back of the head with my staff.
All right.
Bop. What skill is staff?
That is the skill... of
melee weapons.
Melee weapons and then staves.
GR.
Yes.
I have a strong 0 at GR.
Ooh.
So I am rolling 3 to bop him in the back of the head with a quarter staff.
Alright.
Did it not click? Why does my mouse not click?
Its battery's dying.
I'm going to 1 success to hit him in the back of the head.
And he turns as he's taken damage from the sword, sees your staff, and rolls to the side to avoid the blow.
No!
Ah, you traitor!
I tripped.
Thorn has run. Crazy. Taren has run. And then this guy, even though the soldier had cut him, the woman traitor needs to die. Who shoots at her? With 1 success to hit.
I have a feeling I'm taking that regardless.
Could be.
Why is my dodge so high?
What is it?
4.
That's not very high.
So, do I roll 3 plus 4?
Yes.
I have to get 1 success. What?
Are you sure that 4 isn't added? Because you don't have any grace.
Yeah, I think it's just...
That 4 might be the 3 already added in.
Your grace is 0, right?
Yes.
But what is your, because it's based on reflex.
2. So,
which is speed plus perception.
Perception's 3, speed is 1.
Ah, there you go.
So that's why it's 4.
So yeah, it's 7.
I don't want to be shy.
That'll do, Paige.
No, you don't. You don't want to be shot at all.
I'm going to do the Matrix thing where I lean back with my crit success.
Ooh, that is a crit success, too.
That is a crit.
And so... another innocent woman.
redirect the bullet into the fruit vendor.
Guys, just killing all these innocent.
Just how like much you dodge, like the airwave just moves the bullet so slightly.
You dodge so well that you boomerang the bullet back into the guy and he dies.
So strong.
You really matrix it. Just stop the bullet.
There's not really much to do with a critical dodge, so
can start running away.
Yeah, you can move a few squares if you want.
I dodge so hard, I'm gonna run away.
Yeah.
I wanted to move one more.
You dodge behind Alder. That's perfect.
That's fine. I'll take it.
Yeah. Now shoot Alder's me again, you jerk.
All right. Yeah. So. That the 13, and then I'm gonna strike again with overhead. Ooh, only 3 successes.
Hey, you roll like
me. Ooh,
take that.
Dun dun dun.
Ooh.
Ta-da. Ah. Time for a roll off.
I'll go first.
You only got a 3. Oh no, you got a 1.
No, 5.
No, you got a 5.
You got a 5. You hit him. Never mind. I'm a silly goof.
So 26 damage.
Ouch.
Oh, fuck.
Another man missing his other half. Blah. All right. You two are left there, and you hear the marching of what sounds like a couple dozen people arriving. So, you know, you might not want to be there.
I just take off. I sheath my sword, take off my tunic with my holy symbol on, and just stuff it in just so I'm just armored. I grab this man and I sling him over my shoulder.
All right.
Where'd those two bumbling idiots go?
I don't know, but we need to go north. I'll take you to a door. We'll get away from him there.
Let's go.
Is this building to the northeast actually a building, or can I, like, sneak through, like, the alleyway?
There is an alley, but it is, yeah, there's our buildings, and there is, like, a tight alley right here.
My initial thought was, like, it was one of those bridges on the second floor. But...
Oh. No, these are just built awkwardly close to each other. And there's, a few feet between the two buildings.
A few feet. I think both of us can fit through that in single file line.
This is probably true.
Let's go.
And it is your turn, Arave.
I would take my leave... as soon as my mouse works.
Alright.
It's not working. I'll use this mouse.
Alright. You guys flee the scene. Congratulations.
He wasn't supposed to be shocked.
That's where this episode on YouTube would end, and we are going to take a 5-minute break.